Hi, this is Matt from recordinghacks.com. Welcome to the Microphone Show. Tonight we'll be listening to a studio standard. It's the Neumann U87. And we'll compare it to another studio standard, also the Neumann U87. That's right, we have two of them. One is old, one is new, and the question is, which one sounds better? Let's find out.
This episode of the Microphone Show was made possible by Front End Audio, your ultimate pro audio dealer.
Trying to catch your heart is like trying to catch a star. So many people love you, baby. That must be what you are. Waiting for a star to fall and carry your heart into my arms. That's where you belong, in my arms, baby, yeah. Yeah. Trying to catch your heart is like trying to catch a star. So many people love you, baby. That must be what you are. Waiting for a star to fall and carry your heart into my arms. That's where you belong, in my arms, baby, yeah.
Hey everybody, thanks for tuning in to The Mike Show. Coming to you from the beautiful Loudville studio on the ground floor of the Loudville building in sunny Sausalito, California. Once again, thanks for tuning into The Mike Show. We're coming to you from the Loudville studio on the ground floor of the Loudville building in beautiful Sausalito, California.
By way of introduction, we just heard the U87Ai, which is the older mic, and the U87Ai, which is the newer one. And there are some differences between the mics. They have the same capsule and the same body and the same head basket. The primary difference is the polarization voltage of the capsule. So the old one, the U87Ai, runs at, I think, 46 volts. And the new one, the AI, runs at 60. And the effect of that change is that the newer one has higher sensitivity and higher signal-to-noise ratio. But the capsules and most of the audio circuitry is identical. And so the question that we had was, do they sound different? And if so, which one do we like better? So before we get into that, Matt, why don't you walk us through the signal chain?
Okay. We had a pretty simple setup. For this, we just went directly into the Hardy M1, straight into our Digi 192, into Pro Tools. We didn't use any EQ or compression, and what you're hearing is the raw tracks that we recorded.
And the pads and filters were all disabled on the mics?
Yes, that's correct.
My impressions were that the old mic sounded fuller to me, especially hearing the VO and the guitar. I was hearing much more of the more high end on that one. I was hearing a lot more of the higher harmonics in the guitar, for example, and a lot of the more clicky sounds in the VO. And for those applications, I think I preferred it. But on the singing, on George Merrill's singing, I think I actually preferred the newer one, the AI. I think I was hearing a lot more mid-range kind of in that mic rather than the old one, and it's really, to me, lended itself well to the singing. So those are my main impressions.
And I had the reverse impressions, but you're English, so, you know, what do you do? No, really, I felt the new one, the AI, had more body and was less bright than the vintage version. And you did mention what year the vintage one might have, I mean, somewhere.
Yeah, so the AI came out in 86. So the vintage one has to be older than that.
Okay.
We don't know when it...
When it went...
No.
When, okay.
No, I'll find out and put it on the website.
In general, I felt more proximity from the new mic. This may be the wrong term, but that was what I was feeling, more closeness and less. I felt the mid-range to high-end on the old one sounded just a little either more pronounced or a little bit tinnier than on the other one. How about you?
Yeah, I felt like the new one almost sounded like it came pre-EQ'd a little bit. Kind of felt like it had this 10K boost.
Who's here?
And on the voiceover, I didn't really like it as much because I feel like it accented the S's and, you know, some of the other sibilant words. I preferred the older one on the voiceover and on the singing. On the acoustic guitar, I liked them both. I think either one of them would have been a really workable track for whatever, you know, the application. But I probably like the newer one better on the acoustic. Thank you, sir. Probably like the newer one better on the acoustic guitar.
Thank you, sir.
One thing that was really obvious as soon as we started plugging microphones in was the gain differences in both the microphones. You know, the old one required a lot more gain to get it to be a matched level as far as coming close to the new one.
Right. And so if you had a colored preamp or a lower end preamp than the M1, I think what you would probably hear in terms of a difference between these two mics is the preamp.
Yeah.
Anna, what did you hear?
For me, I felt like there was definitely a bump somewhere in the mid-range section for the newer mic. It had more of a warmth. But I liked that warmth. It sounded really good, particularly on the guitar and the vocals. But it also accentuated the higher frequencies in certain places on the voiceover that I wasn't so sure that I liked. And I might have preferred the older mic for that use for the voiceover. It's a really finite difference. It's really interesting to hear the detail between the two, though.
So the question I have is, if you had both these mics in a session, could you punch in one for a track on the other?
My answer would be yes.
Yeah,
absolutely. It's very close.
Yeah,
we're being very nitpicky.
We are. I wanted to say the difference when I talk about or when I express my opinion on this. Really, the difference is small.
Yeah.
And we were sitting here for a couple of hours or an hour and a half, kind of listening. So you become quite acutely tuned. But if I walked into a room and had 2 minutes to evaluate them, it would be, they're very, very close.
And if I wanted to use them as a pair on my drum kit for overheads, would that probably fly?
I'd think you'd be cheating, but...
which side would you put the AI on, and which side the eye? That's the question.
Oh, well, I would put the AI on the snare side.
Right.
Myself.
Good to know.
But if you're from England, you would put it somewhere else.
Yeah. Kick drum.
Well, I'm curious what you meant when you said proximity difference between the two mics.
I feel that there's a bump in the bottom that exists on the new one that doesn't exist on the old one. Now, I would equate that normally with proximity, but I don't know if theoretically the capsules are identical and the electronics are identical. I don't have an answer, a why, to that. But that was my, that's what I heard. I just felt this thickness on the bottom. I'm thinking that you described it as mid-range.
Yeah, I mean, are you talking
and
about...
And it's really lower
it's
than
low
mid-range.
Mid, yeah.
So what, are you talking about like 300 to 500? That's kind of where I'm
think I'm talking about 60 to 150, you know, something that's more low. Or 200 maybe, you know.
And was it always there or did it kind of come and go?
I heard it on every test, but less on the singing test. But he was also singing in a very high register.
Yeah. Yeah.
The announcer test, that would be a no-brainer because, I mean, that's where you're going to hear that.
Yeah.
I felt like I noticed a little more transient in the newer mic, and maybe that was just me, or maybe I noticed we adjusted the level at one point to make sure that they were right, but the newer mic seemed like it had more transient, more attack than the older mic did.
Yeah, like it had a faster response or something like that to some of the sounds.
Maybe there was some natural compression on the older mic.
Yeah.
I kind of felt the reverse of that. The end result being the new mic had a slightly smoother sound, which isn't what I would associate with more transients. Mm-hmm. I felt it sounded more radio.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, and you weren't doing anything to them.
Right.
To me, it just sounded, it had that. That famous Mark Keller sound more, you know.
So as subtle as the differences are, let's take a show of hands. I mean, who's now shopping for an AI and who's holding out on eBay for the old one? I'll start. Mm-hmm. I like the AI. I don't know what it is. It sounded better to me.
Yep.
Ever so slightly.
I'm with you.
I'd have to agree.
I really preferred the old one on the voiceover. Mm-hmm. And I think on the singing, but on the acoustic guitar, I like the extra sparkle that the AI seemed to give the recording.
I like the old one on the guitar, the VO, but I like the new one on the singing, but then I could just EQ the old one.
Right.
So,
right.
So I'd go with the old one.
Right on. 3-2.
But do you want to tell them now that actually it was always the same mic, just one in a shock mount and one not?
The punchline. Yeah.
So that's it for the Microphone Show episode 2. If you haven't seen it already, Microphone Show episode 1 is right here. Special thanks to Loudville, a wonderful studio in Sausalito, California. Check them out at loudville.tv. And that's it. Until next time.